Ever since the beginning of time, people have been intrigued by the mystery of life. Where do we come from? Why are we the way we are? In a revolutionary discovery, James Watson, Francis Crick, Maurice Wilkins, and Rosalind Franklin answer this age-old question. The reaction throughout the scientific community rang loud, reforming and improving modern biological and medical sciences. The discovery of the structure of DNA has led to a better understanding of DNA and has created a vaster understanding of genetic diseases and knowledge of how life recreates. A basic awareness of genes and DNA was not new to Watson and Crick, as Austrian scientist Gregor Mendel had already discovered the gene, and in 1865 published his findings in a monograph called Experiments on Plant Hybrids, Revolutionizing the Field of Genetics. After Mendel's work, the field of genetics started becoming more accepted. In 1869, scientist Frederick Miescher was working in his lab in Germany when he accidentally discovered DNA by putting pus in a weak alkaline concentrate, leaving only a reformed state of DNA. This he called nuclei. Then, in 1944, Oswald Avery, McLean McCarty, and Colin McLeod, working at the Rockefeller University in New York, showed through extensive experiments that DNA was the genetic material and not proteins as many had believed.
And divided, purified out the protein, the DNA, and the RNA, which one of these components is able to transfer the virulence from the avirulent bugs to the virulent bugs? To everyone's shock and amazement, it was the DNA. Okay, so I take a molecule now which no one had cared about since it was discovered by Friedrich Miescher, right? I've now taken that from being this, and all of a sudden with the experiment of Avery, McCarthy, and McLeod, it moves to center stage in the study of genetics.
Their findings led to the advancement of research of DNA in many labs around the world. In order to understand what DNA was, scientists in the 1940s tried to create models of DNA. One of the leading scientists in the field at the time, Austrian biochemist Erwin Chargaff, reformed the study of DNA when he noticed a pattern in the amounts of the four main bases: adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine. This discovery later helped with the final conclusion of Watson and Crick.
In 1951, J.T. Randall, the current conductor of the physics department at King's College, recruited Rosalind Franklin as an X-ray crystallographer. In September of 1951, Franklin discovered that there were actually two forms of DNA, dry form A and wet form B. In the same year, while working at Cavendish Laboratory, James Watson, an American scientist, and Francis Crick, an English scientist, became partners in the race to find the structure of DNA. Using many ideas from American researcher Linus Pauling's, they decided to go straight to building a model. Their first model, a triple helical replica of DNA, was a misconception. The university reacted by discouraging Watson and Crick from working any longer on DNA. As 1952 dawned, Rosalind Franklin and fellow researcher Raymond Gosling found a dead end in crystalline X-ray form A. Franklin continued working day and night to perfect the B form, and on her 51st X-ray photo, she got it right. It was mid-1952, and Watson and Crick were extremely discouraged. When Linus Pauling's triple helix paper was published, they knew he was wrong, so they began their research again at Cavendish Laboratory, getting straight to work with their new colleague, Peter Pauling, the son of Linus Pauling.
By 1953, Franklin had no idea that the race for the double helix had started. However, she looked again at photo 51 and concluded that both forms A and B were made up of helical chains, so she reacted by continuing further research to find the structure. Watson and Crick had actually discovered the structure of DNA on February 28, 1953. They quickly shared their findings at a pub in Cambridge known as the Eagle. On April 25th, Watson and Crick published their revolutionary discoveries in a one-page paper, A Structure for Deoxyribose Nucleic Acid, in the British scientific weekly Nature.
Did her photograph, or whatever you call it, contribute to it?
Oh, sure, because when I saw it, I had to be a helix.
This monumental discovery was the end of the race for life. Unfortunately for them, their victory was tainted. They had stolen the work of fellow researcher Franklin and passed it as their own. In 1962, the Nobel Foundation awarded Watson, Crick, and Wilkins the Nobel Prize for Physiology and Medicine, reacting to their discovery. Sadly, Franklin, whose work was stolen by Watson and Crick, died in 1958 and could not be nominated for a Nobel Prize. To this day, she is still known as the Dark Lady of DNA.
It was impossible. You only can give a Nobel Prize to three people, so there have been four of us. So the Swedes could have given two prizes.
Her work, along with the work of all the DNA scientists, has led to many reforms in science. One of the major effects was our instant knowledge of how life recreates itself with some regularity. Each strand of DNA holds a certain gene. All of these genes together make up who we are and how we grow. Because of this discovery, we now know the structure of DNA is rather like a spiral staircase. When the gene reproduces, it goes through a process of mitosis. This is when the gene divides into two identical strands of DNA. Thus, the physical characteristics of a child are like the parent. Starting in 1973, scientists began to genetically engineer plants to make them bigger, seedless, or even a different color. A similar process has been used to create clones of plants and animals. The first cloned mammal was a sheep, Dolly, cloned in 1996. The Roslin Institute in Scotland created Dolly from an adult cell. Dolly was the only living clone out of the many attempted. She died in 2003. Now, because of her, scientists understand how to clone. Also, the cloning process used to make Dolly has led to a reform in cloning.
Another branch of DNA research is DNA splicing. There is talk that by using this method, soon humans may be able to shape children before they are born. In order to discover and understand the DNA of living things, scientists use a process called DNA sequencing. This process has been used as a basis for many projects and scientific breakthroughs since 1976, when Alan Maxim and Walter Gilbert used chemical modification to sequence DNA. Today, we have used it to sequence the human genome and in DNA modification. This project was completed in 2003. Humans are now reading the genome.
Having the complete human genome sequence has in turn led to things like the Human Genome Diversity Project.
Once they understand it, scientists will know humans at the most basic level. Once they know the human genome, the scientists can react by changing us, and doctors can cure diseases more easily. In recent years, the fact that each person has their own unique DNA has been used in the enforcement of criminal justice. Like many cases around the world, in 1999, the New York Police Department used DNA to convict a man for a chain of sexual assaults and robberies. Also, because of the discovery of the structure of DNA, the science community is now investigating ways to prevent harmful genetic diseases such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, and has discovered that paranoid schizophrenia can be prevented with pills, therapy, or special lifestyles. Mankind has always been intrigued by where we come from. Because of the work of James Watson, Francis Crick, Maurice Wilkins, and Rosalind Franklin, we are now beginning to understand. We know the reason we can reproduce and pass on our genes. Although Franklin may have reacted poorly to Watson and Crick stealing her work, they still had a large impact on the world. Watson and Crick created a revolution by finding the structure of DNA, but they could not have found it without the work of the other scientists. The Nobel Prize Watson, Crick, and Wilkins received is a symbol of their accomplishment. The revolutionary discovery of the structure of DNA has reformed science so much more than the researchers could ever have imagined.